Hi, I'm Kimberly Calderbank for Community Cultures. Extracurricular activities help children build social skills, self-esteem, stay healthy, whether that's mentally, emotionally, or physically. Researchers have found there is a definite effect on participation on important outcomes like reading and math achievement, course grades, sense of belonging to the school, and academic self-concepts. Results strongly suggest that participating in extracurricular activities cause students' academic performance and overall well-being to increase. This past year, extracurricular activities have taken a hard hit, and we know our youngest community members are struggling to feel connected. Today's guests have made adaptations to their businesses to allow children to still connect with extracurricular activities and friends. And they both are helping out others in their community as well through community giving programs. It's a win-win. Juno Award winner Susie McNeil was born to make music. From a very early age, she learned the art of musical collaboration by singing with her mother and sister in their Mississauga home. Since then, her passion, hard work, and determination has led to an impressive and diverse career on stage, on screen, and in the studio. With a whole country cheering her on, Susie became a household name in 2005 when she was the last woman standing on the CBCS reality show Rockstar in Excess. Since then, she has continued to make Canada proud, recording Believe in 2009, a song that became the anthem for the 2010 Canadian Olympic team. With an impressive music career and partnerships, Susie's desire to support others in pursuit of their musical dreams continues to grow. Today, she works mentoring many budding musicians through Burlington Music Academy. Susie, we all know how incredibly important the arts and music are. What does the arts and music mean to you?
Everything. Since I was a little kid, my mom sings, so she used to sing with my sister and I, just because she loved it so much. And little did I know, back in the day when she was singing with us, she would make us like sing harmonies and stuff in long car rides. And we learned how to sing from her. And again, it didn't come from anything other than her love for it. And then it just stayed with actually both my sister and I forever. So we kind of dedicated our lives to the arts in different facets. She's a high school music teacher in Toronto. And I'm the second child. So whenever we would sing our three-part harmonies, I would always want to take the lead. Like I was showing that desire for performance from a very young age. And then, you know, that was, the arts were what got me through school. The arts and singing, you know, it's so incredibly like healthy for our development and our minds. And our biggest thing is our confidence. Mm-hmm. You know, it helped lead me through tough times. It was always the most important thing. And I think that a passion like that really helps the youth, especially right now, more than ever.
We talk about, you know, music and the arts building community and how it brings people together. You were talking about your family. I have a little performer in my house as well that just second child loves to be the star of the show. And it's certainly something that just inspires happiness. And that's what we need right now. So how has being a part of music built community for you?
It's just been incredible. I mean, before COVID, I was a touring musician. So it was, I had a community, but it was very much sort of pick up and leave. That's been one silver linings for myself during COVID is when my husband and I started this music school, we really wanted to reach out to the community. And now more than ever, you know, when music isn't actually really being allowed, I mean, you can't even sing in school right now. We thought that there was a very important need to, you know, keep it going because the arts have always kind of faced a little bit of a challenge all through, you know, funding and keeping it in schools and things like that. So, you know, it didn't really need another thing like this to challenge it. But, you know, we're determined to, we had this dream before the the pandemic. My husband is born and raised in Burlington. And then once we had our child, we moved here. And we always just had a dream more of a physical space. So we wanted a space, and we're still going to do it when the time is right, where, you know, high school students like from Central or the surrounding schools could come after school. We're going to have like a cafe and like a proper stage with lighting. We're going to have open mic afternoons, you know, jams, baby circle times. We just want it to be like a real community-based cool hang for people who, and especially kids are so important to us, who need that outlet. And, you know, I think it's lacking right now, but this is the time to create it and to make it happen.
So Susie, you're referencing Burlington Music Academy. This is a new business that you and your business partner slash husband have created together. What a time to start a business, first and foremost. As you mentioned, this is a time where we're hearing about a lot of businesses not working out, and you've taken the plunge into this academy. You've started virtual with the purpose to land face-to-face. What sort of virtual classes are you offering now, and how are you seeing that connectivity with the community?
That's something that I'm really enjoying, is the connectivity, because I feel like there's such a lack of it right now, that's a real mission that my husband and I want to be a part of. And it's been just wonderful. We offer, you know, one-on-one lessons, and we also are trying to think outside the box to, again, bring people together. We offer a group ukulele class that happens every Sunday, and they all call it church because they all gather at 10 a.m. and they learn a nice ukulele song. I've been trying to do more sort of virtual choirs. I'm doing one this week, actually, where we get together, learn harmonies. Everyone's going to record their part separately, and then we're going to make a recording of it. We're going to do Lean on Me. So I also think I want to do like a little video and get all the kids involved, and, you know, always just trying to find a way to brighten spirits. I'm a big fan of, if we can get together virtually, to do so. We've been doing a lot of recitals, which have been amazing on Sunday. We do them on Sundays. We charge a little ticket price on Google Meet, and then we give all of it to the Hamilton Music Collective, who are doing amazing things for people who want to play and want to take lessons and can't afford it. So we're always trying to bring people together through music. And when we first started, I was like, is this going to work? You know, it's such a something you would want to do in person, obviously, like all the other things. But I've just found the response to be incredible. And the thing that makes me the happiest is when people say that it's raised their confidence level. That's just something that is not really tangible, and you can't like teach it, and it doesn't come in a book, but how important is that for
people? Absolutely. And that well-being and that sense of belonging is so strong and so very much needed, especially for our youth right now. I love that you mentioned the Hamilton Musicians Collective, because there's lots of things that you're doing from a giving back perspective and engaging externally of your business community. Can you tell us a little bit more about the partnerships that you have within community?
Yes, we've done, I mean, we're quite a new company, so we launched at the end of last year, but we hooked up with the Sound of Music Fest pretty early, which is a great match for us because my husband and I both come from live touring and shows and stuff, and they want to do so much more for the community as well. We did a speaker series. We're going to do another one. I speak at high schools about like the music business and how to get, you know, if you want to be a star, how to go about that. And then we're also talking to the Sound of Music to do more in the future. I probably shouldn't say right now, but it's actually very exciting. And then, you know, we just try to, with our small little community that we have, we're always just trying to offer sort of free connectivity programs or interactions, because I feel like when you wake up on a Saturday and you know that you're gonna you know, do a sing-along with your child and me at 11 a.m. that's just something to like schedule in your day and keep you motivated and keep you your spirits up and happy. So we do that, we do the circle time, we do like music story time, we do, like I said, the speaker series, and we're always looking for, we did some performances for the Burlington Counselor. You know, as soon as anyone asks us to do anything that we know how to do, I guess we always agree. We're there for any request that anyone, you know, has of us. And like I said, our biggest mission would be giving music back. So in any way that we can fill a youth's life with an opportunity or an instrument, anything like that is very near and dear to our hearts.
You, one of the things that I heard when I was preparing for this interview and asking is certainly Susie, oh, she's awesome. And they're always here. Or they're doing this for the community. So we know you're very involved and you certainly have that reputation in the community. So thank you for all you're doing. But one big piece that you left out, Susie, and that I'd love to talk about, and you mentioned raising spirits, was the Joseph Brandt Hospital. You mentioned that you had been singing and performing for them as well. Can you tell us a little bit about the raising of spirits that you've done there too?
Yes. Well, I mean, because my husband and I were both touring musicians, when the pandemic hit, we were kind of just floored. And we started off, again, with raising spirits. We wanted to do, we went online and did a few songs every single night, like in last year's lockdown. We made sure it was very important to us and to others. It was kind of a cathartic experience for music. And then we decided in the summer, when the weather got nicer, to do sort of, we called them driveway shows, block parties, where we would go anywhere kind of in the GTA to perform on people's driveways. We did them a bunch on our own driveway. We did food drives and a lot through the holidays, and then gave the proceeds and actual canned goods to the food bank. And then we were so lucky, and because we were looking for a way to try to give back to first responders, and we were so lucky to be invited to do one outside of Joe Brandt Hospital. And I was crying. I was trying to sing and crying and just, you know, between my husband and I, we played in front of thousands. And I think I used to sing backup for Pink. So I feel like it was the biggest crowd. Wow. I had, like 250,000, I'm saying. But I say this, and it's absolutely true, is that these block parties that we were doing last summer were more meaningful than anything I had ever played in my life. Like, we had people, neighbors from down the street, coming up and crying and thanking us and saying, this has been so hard and I haven't heard live music in so long. And it's just so wonderful how it can touch people in the deepest places.
Music truly has the ability to bring people together, to lift spirits, to encourage. For your business plan and for moving forward with Burlington Music Academy, what is your vision for continuing to build that community?
Definitely a physical space. I feel like when you're one-on-one with people, when we're able to tangibly do things together, that makes a big difference. We want to just offer sort of as many opportunities in music through our academy as possible. We want to do like super fun things. I can't wait till I can have some of my students like get up on the Sound of Music stage and like perform for a bunch of people. We just have like really, really big dreams. And, you know, we're working on right now, my husband was thinking of like getting an older guitar and like setting it up and making it great, and then outreaching to somebody who maybe can't afford the guitar and really wants to play. We have all little projects that we'll be releasing through the months, as the coming months as well.
Well, thank you, Susie, for joining us today, and certainly for all you do for the community. It's incredible when we start to, you know, chat with people about what you're doing that maybe you don't even recognize how important it is to everybody around you and how much it's truly inspiring others. I'm actually a neighbor of yours, Susie, and so I have seen your block parties. I've heard, and I know how much it meant to the neighbors here and how much it meant to Joe Brandt as well. So thank you for all you and your husband are doing. Best wishes with your company as you move forward, and thank you for joining us today.
Thank you so much, Kimberly.